Hello students, in this video we will discuss the solution of question number 8, 9 and 10 from the exercises of chapter number 3. Question number 8 says, what can we say about a subgroup of D3 that contains R40 and a reflection F? And second part is, what can you say about a subgroup of D3 that contains two reflections? So there are two parts in this question. So as we know that in D3 there are six elements, so let us write first all the elements of D3: R0, R120, R240, and then X1, then X2, and then X3. As we know that these are the rotation, and X1, X2 and X3 are reflections. So the question is, there is a subgroup of D3 that contains R40. So let H be that subgroup of D3 and it contains R40 to R240 and a reflection F that belongs to H. We recall that two step test about a subgroup of the given group, that if H is a subgroup, if at all H has to be a subgroup of G, then it should satisfies two conditions, that AB should be belongs to H for all AB belongs to H, and B inverse should be in H for all B belongs to H. That is, when we are taking two elements A and B in H, their composition belongs to H, and every element of B has its inverse in H. So with the help of this one, since R240 belongs to H, so this implies that because H is a subgroup of D3, so R240 square, and this is equals to R120 R240 R240 cube, and this is equals to R360, and this is nothing but R0. So what we see, that R0, R120 and R240 all belongs to H because of this property. Now as we saw that R0, R120, R240 belongs to H, and also we have been given that a reflection F belongs to H. So because of closure property, as H is a subgroup of D3, so R120 F, R240 F, and of course F already is a member of H, should be member of H. So what we have, this subgroup H has how many elements? R0, R120, R240, R120 F, R240 F, and F itself. Of course one can talk about that, what about when we take F R120. So this is nothing but this is equals to R120 inverse of this one and F, and inverse of R120 is R240 and this is F. So whatever other combination we will take between rotation and reflection, So their combination will be among these only. So among these three. So how many elements are there? There are six elements. They are distinct, and of course they are the only the member of D3 only. So H is nothing but D3, complete D3. So whenever we have R240 and a reflection, we are getting that subgroup has to be the whole group D3. Even we can take one R120, if we take R120, then also we can find a square and cube of that element, and then we can compute other elements also. Then in that case also we will be getting the same subgroup, that is D3 only. So second part is, what can you say about the subgroup, a subgroup of D3 that contains two reflections? So here we go. Let S be another subgroup of D3, and there are two reflections. Two reflections, let us suppose F1 and F2. They are reflections. They are reflections, belongs to S. Then, as we know, if you see the table, if you are taking any reflection, so suppose x1 and x1, then we are getting rotation, and if we are taking x1 and x2, we are getting again a rotation. So two reflection, composition of two reflection always give a rotation. So here, of course, let us assume, because reflections are self-inverse, so F1 is not equals to F2, because if F1 equals to F2, F1 equals to F2, then F1 F2 equals to F1 square, that is equals to identity, that is R0. So there, in that case, there will be only one element, R0. So this will be a trivial subgroup of D3. So when F1 and F2 are distinct, then we must have F1 F2 equals to either R120 or R240. As we see, we can see from the table, if we take here x1 and here x2, then we are getting R120. Or in other case, if we may get R240. But in any case, we may get F1, F2 equals to R120 or R240. So if F1 and F2 equals to R120, then F2 and F1 equals to R240. So if these R120 and R240, they are members of S, because F1 and F2 belongs to S. So their composition will be a member of S, as S is a subgroup of D3. So how many elements until now we have? R120 and R240. If we square it two times, then we get R240, and if we put R120 cube of this one, then we can get R360, that is R0. So we have all rotations. We have all rotations, R0, R120 and R240. And we have two reflections, F1 and F2. Now we can use the first part, that it contains R240 and a reflection. So here we have more than that. We have R240 also, we have R120 also, we have R0 also, and there are two reflections are there. So when we compose together all these elements, then we get S is nothing but R0, R120, R240. 240 and other elements of x1 and x2 and x3. So this is equals to nothing but d3. These elements are a reflection and they are coming through various combination of these reflections and the rotations, like r120, f1, r120, f2 and etc. Now consider the next question, question number 9. What we can say about a subgroup of d4 that contains one rotation and a reflection? So we will proceed in a similar manner, but before that let us recall one thing, that the group dn in general, the dihedral group, is defined by r sub identity element, then r square and r cube dot 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 up to r to the power n. This is n minus 1, and then we have reflection f. If I have one reflection here f, then other elements are rf, then r square f, r cube f. We can write them like this. So finally r to the power n minus 1 f, and with the condition r to the power n is identity and f flip is square is also identity, and r f equals to r inverse f. So this is the definition of in general dn. So when we know rotations, we can generate other flips by just multiplying them with rotation. We know one rotation and we can generate other rotations, and with the help of if we are given one flip, then other flips can be generated with the help of these rotations and one given flip by multiplying them. So here we have been given in d4, what we can write? Identity r square and r cube, and then one flip is there, and then rf, r square f, r cube f. So these many elements, total 4 elements, and 4 elements are there, and here r to the power 4 equals to identity, and this is equals to f square, and rf equals to r inverse f. Here r is nothing but r90. So let us start. So here have been given r270. Let us see if we can generate other rotations with the help of this one. So r270, when we square, we will get r180, r180, and then r cube 270. This is equals to r180. We need to do r cube, that is r180 into r270. This is equals to r90, and then r270 to the power 4 equals to r0. So we have all rotations r0, r90, r180, r180, and of course r270 is given here. So one reflection is given. So with the help of this one, we can, by definition, we can generate this whole group. So this will give us. We have r0, r90, r180, and r270. So if f is given, a given flip, so r90f, and f is given flip, r90f, r180 f, and r, we can write like this, just like आर 90 स्क्वायर एफ एंड आर 90 क्यूब एफ. सो दिस इज द ग्रुप नथिंग बट D4 if we compare with this one. So once we have one rotation non-identity and one reflection, we can generate the whole group with the help of these two elements. So essentially this will give, these two elements will give rise a subgroup which is nothing but D4. So this subgroup S is equals to this one, and this is nothing but D4. So let us consider the next question. What we can say about a subgroup of D4 that contains H and D. So here we see H and D. So when we combine H and D are different distinct reflections. So they will give rise a rotation. So either they will, when we combine these two, either we can get R90 or we can get from here R270. So among these we can get any. So second part is H and D. What is H and D? D is here. So we are getting R90. So R90 and DH equals to R270. Of course, with the help of these two, R90, we can get R180, R270 is already there, and R90 to the power 4, 4 times we can combine this, then we get R0. So we have R0, R90, R180, and R270. We got all rotations. So interesting thing is that what we see, we have been given two reflections H and D. So when we combine them, suppose we are writing R180 into H. So what we get? R180 from here and H. So we are getting vertical flip. So this is nothing but vertical flip. Now consider R180 and D. So R180 and D, we are getting D prime. This is equals to D prime. So thus we got all elements. So from here we have a subgroup. Name it H. We have already R rotations, R0, R90. R180, R270, and we have been given already H and D, and from combination of these we got V and D prime. So this is nothing but D4. So in this case also we got D4 as its subgroup. So once we have been given two rotations, namely horizontal and one diagonal rotation D, we can get the whole group. So consider the next part. What you can say about a subgroup of D4 that contains H and V, horizontal flip and vertical flip. So let us see from here, horizontal flip and vertical flip. We got this one, this and this. So when we combine them, horizontal, so we get one rotation R, that is R0. Of course, when we combine V and V, we get R0 again. But H and V, when combined, we are getting R180. And when V and H are combined, we are getting R180. So, let us see. Third part, we have been given H and V. So H square is R0, of course V square is also R0, h and v equals to r 180, and also, and this is equals to v and h, vh. So with the help of r 0, we can not generate any other element except r 0, this rotation, and h and v is giving an element which is r 180, which is self inverse. So r 180 square, this is equals to r 360, this is nothing but r 0. So how many power we are raising, how much power we are raising, doesn't matter, we will be getting only r 0 and r 180. So with the help of these two elements, we can only get, suppose this is h 1, we can get r 0 and r 180. These are two rotation. We cannot get r 90 and r 180, r 90 and r 270. So, and we have been also given h and v. Other rotations we cannot generate with the help of these two. Or we can see, if we combine r naught and h, then we will get h all the time, and when we combine r naught with v, we will get v all the time. But what we when combine r 180 with h, let us see if we can get some more element. So v and r 180, v and r 180, we are getting horizontal h and r 180 and v, we are getting h. So we are getting only these four elements. So if we have been given two elements, horizontal and vertical flips in a rectangle, in a square, where we are considering T4, the corresponding group. So we are getting only these many elements, and this is a proper subgroup of D4. This is a proper subgroup of D4 having four elements. So now move to next question. How many subgroup of order 4 D4 have? So just we have seen here, one subgroup is here, order 4, R0, R180, H and V. And let us see what other subgroups we can write. So one thing is there, just we have seen in Dn, we have identity element and R square and up to Rn-1. And other elements we can obtain by multiplying them using flip and rotation. So Rf and R square F, so it will go on, and Rn to the n minus 1 F. So with the conditions is Rn equals to identity, that is equals to F square, and Rf equals to R inverse F. So this is the These are the conditions. So order 4. So what we see, rotation is always of order n here. So of in Dn, one subgroup will be D4. In fact, in D4, one subgroup will be the identity element R0, R90, just raised power here R180. R270. So this is one subgroup of order 4. One, let us see H2, another group. So for another group, what we have here, this one, R0, R180, H and V. R0, R180, and H and V. So other subgroups we can have, just like S3 equals to R. We need to keep all those elements, because R0 and R180 are self inverse. So if we are keeping them as self inverse element, so they are self-inverse element, we need two elements which are either they are self-inverse or they are inverse of each other, but in that case we need to also observe the closeness of that set. So these two elements of are self inverse, other elements D and D dash. So they are in fact inverse of self inverse of self. And again one more elements, one more set we can think about H4, which is identity. So there are only four subgroups of three subgroup of order four, and one subgroup is there of order one, and another subgroup is D4 itself. So with this, I'll stop here. We will discuss some other questions in next videos.